Cathy, I want to start with something that Rachel said, talking about this being the year where we see more and more AI agents. One of Sapphire Ventures' predictions is that agents will begin to deliver on hype. I got to tell you, Katie Greifeld sitting right next to me, she's not impressed with AI agents right now. Is she going to be this year?
Well, that's a great question. I have to agree with Rachel. I think you're going to start to see agents come into the scene in a very, very big way. In many ways, the AI agent is a natural evolution of what we saw with AI co-pilots and AI chatbots. So another example would be whereas AI agents are able to autonomously execute actions or entire workflows, chatbots and co-pilots were really more Q&A. And where I get really excited is the fact that if we can automate entire workflows, that frees up so much human capacity to do the more creative and more strategic work. Now, that being said, I do also agree with Katie, right? A lot of the challenges with widespread adoption and implementation of agents will be in what I call kind of the last mile problems. This is the governance, the privacy, the protections. The devil's in the details, and that has yet to be seen.
Okay, agents, one of your predictions. What about when it comes to AI-generated video? Because 2024 was the year we saw a wider release of Sora from OpenAI. I think a lot of people were pretty impressed by that. How are we going to see AI-generated video this year?
I think we're going to see a lot of multimodal in general, Tim, but we're going to see a lot more video, and we're going to see a lot more voice. The models have been developing extremely rapidly. I don't know if you guys have seen some of the recent AI-generated videos from Sora and other video models, but they're incredible. They are starting to feel a lot more lifelike. The latency is being reduced. The same goes with voice. So I think we're going to see much more widespread adoption as individual video and voice applications, as well as full multimodal applications, which means there will be voice, there will be text, there will be video and images combined into one.
Yeah, I've seen some of those videos, and they're pretty creepy. They're very realistic.
Like what? Yes.
Such as if you go on Twitter or X right now, you can find a whole bunch of them. But, okay. Cathy, I want to talk a little bit more about how companies might use AI in the year ahead, because I speak to a lot of investors, and they want to say in the hardware space, investing in the chip makers, because they're not clear yet on how companies will actually use AI and maybe actually boost productivity. Do we get further along in that investment timeline in 2025?
That's such a great question, Katie. Well, let's talk about what happened in 2024 to set the stage for what we think might happen in 2025. In my view, 2024 is a year where AI really went mainstream. 92% of the Fortune 500 adopted Gen AI solutions internally and spent around $14 billion on these solutions. But what's even more importantly, a lot of major companies, so think Walmart, JP Morgan Chase, Microsoft, Google, all announced in their public earnings calls that they've had significant success and significant measurable ROI using their Gen AI projects internally. So that gives me a lot of hope and confidence that A, budgets will continue to expand into 2025. Now, the big question is, can the hype turn into actual proof in a wide-scale manner in 2025? And in order to see that, we're going to have to see more adoption amongst all the employees at a company, not just within certain functions or certain specific projects. And we have to see more guidelines on how we actually measure ROI.